Hey everybody, John Nelson with Haas Automation here today with another video in our metrology series. Today, we're going to introduce you to our comparative gauges. Comparative gauges are gauges that are made to a specific size or shape, and then you use it to compare it with what you're making or a component you're trying to identify. The gauge isn't going to give you a measurement, but you will be able to see if the component matches the gauge size. And many comparative gauges come in a set or a range of sizes so you can narrow down the possibilities. A radius gauge is a perfect example. Each radius gauge comes with two sets of leaves. Each leaf has a different size radius. One set of leaves has the internal or concave radii, and the other set of leaves has the external or convex radii. Our radius gauges come in either inch or metric, and there are three sizes of each. The small metric set is 17 pieces of each internal and external, from 1 to 7 millimeters. The medium metric set is from 7.5 up to 15 millimeters, and the large metric set is from 15.5 up to 25 millimeters. The small inch radius gauges cover the fractional sizes in 64ths, from 1/32 up to 1/4 inch. The medium set, also in 64ths, ranges from 17/64ths up to 1/2 inch. And the large set covers 17/32 up to 1 inch in 1/32 increments. I have this part and I want to know what radius it has. So I find a radius gauge that looks close and hold it up to the component. It's either going to match or it's not. If it doesn't, I'm going to try some other leaves to see if I can find the best match. Angle gauges are very similar to radius gauges. They're made of hardened stainless steel with fine machined edges. The leaves or blades are beveled at the various angles, and they're used in the same way to compare the angle of the component with the angle on the gauge to determine the degree of the angle. The set has 20 gauges that come in 1 degree increments from 1 to 10 degrees, 2 degree increments from 12 to 20 degrees, and 5 degree increments from 25 to 45 degrees. The angles are accurate to plus or minus 30 minutes. A feeler gauge is another type of comparative gauge used in many industries, including precision machinery, mold making, and electronic equipment. Feeler gauges are used to measure gaps for practically any purpose. The 32-leaf set is made of hardened spring steel and then polished for a smooth, durable finish. The thickness of each leaf is etched with both the inch and metric sizes from 0.04 millimeter up to 0.8 millimeters, which converts to 1/1/2 up to 35/1 of an inch. The set also includes one copper feeler that's 10/1 or 0.25 millimeters thick for measuring magnetic components. The set comes with a nickel-plated case and a lock nut to keep them in place. Next, we have thread pitch gauges. These gauges have the thread form of various size thread pitches and are used to check the pitch of existing screw threads. You determine the correct pitch of the thread by comparing the thread form on the leaf to the threads on the component. The leaves are designed so they can be used on internal or external threads. The leaves are made from premium stainless steel and are precision ground and finished. Each leaf is marked with the thread size for simple thread size determination. The sets have a locking screw to hold the leaves in place during measurement or during storage. There are two sets available, and each set has two separate sets of thread pitch gauges. The first contains a set of 24 metric 60 degree pitch gauges from 0.25 to 6 millimeter pitch. The other set is 28 Whitworth 55 degree gauges from 4 to 62 threads per inch. The second set has 22 metric 60 degree gauges from 0.4 millimeters to 7 millimeters pitch. The other end of that set has 30 unified 60 degree pitch gauges from 4 to 42 threads per inch. The universal cutter point angle gauge is another super useful comparative gauge. It's a must-have for every machinist and CNC program. The gauge has 8 of the most common cutter point angles, so you can quickly tell which point angle a drill or cutter has. This information is key when you're determining how deep to program a drill so you get the correct full diameter depth. The gauge has angles of 60, 82, 90, 118, 120, 135, 150, and 160 degrees. It's made of premium polished stainless steel, and like all the comparative gauges, comes in a heavy-duty vinyl pouch. The angle thread cutting gauge is sometimes referred to as a center gauge or a fishtail gauge. It's extremely handy when you're grinding your own 60 degree single point thread cutting tool. Students, hobbyists, and manual lathe machinists will benefit from this gauge. It can be used to verify the 60 degree included angle on a tailstock center. The gauge can also be used to determine the angle of existing screw threads. Each gauge also has a ruler section to aid in determining the pitch of the threads. We carry them in metric 60 degrees with two 2.5 centimeter ruler sections. One is graduated in 0.5 millimeter lines, and the other side is 1 millimeter graduations. The unified 60 degree version has 4 1-inch long ruler sections with graduations in 14ths, 20ths, 24ths, and 32nds of an inch for finding the number of threads per inch. The Whitworth is a 55 degree gauge, also with graduations in 14ths, 20ths, 24ths, and 32nds of an inch. The ACME screw thread gauge is used in the same way that the angle thread cutting gauge is used. It's the standard for comparison when grinding ACME thread cutting tools. There's an outstanding video about how to use an ACME threading gauge when grinding your own ACME threading tool, and we'll put a link to that video in the description below. If you're not familiar with ACME threads, they have a 29 degree included angle and a very specific nose width based on the number of threads per inch. We can see the different width notches labeled with the number of threads per inch. This carbide ACME threading insert fits this notch, so it's for cutting 2 threads per inch threads. The gauge has thread pitches from 1 to 10 threads per inch. The edges are all hardened and precision ground to make sure this tool lasts a lifetime and then some. Wire gauges and sheet metal gauges are really handy tools to quickly identify the gauge of wire or thickness of sheet metal. Both gauges are made from hardened stainless steel, which produces a heavy-duty gauge that's built to last. The wire gauge is made to the American standard for gauging non-ferrous wire like copper, brass, and aluminum. The gauge numbers range from 0 to 36 and include the decimal inch equivalents of the wire gauges etched on the back. The sheet metal gauge is made to the American standard for sheet and plate, iron and steel. Again, the gauge numbers are from 0 to 36 and the decimal equivalents are etched on the back. And finally, we have the small hole gauge set. This small hole gauge is worth every penny. The ability to accurately measure hole size, roundness, and taper on holes down to 3 millimeters or 118 thousandths of an inch is invaluable. Operation couldn't be simpler. Unscrew the drawbar and insert the gauge into the hole. As the fingers expand, wiggle the gauge and slowly tighten the drawbar. Stop tightening the drawbar when the friction on the gauge prevents easy movement, and then pull the gauge out of the hole. Now, just measure the gauge with an OD micrometer. The entire set will measure holes from 3 millimeter or 118 thousandths of an inch up to 13 millimeters or 511 thousandths of an inch. The long reach design allows you to measure holes that are quite deep while still being able to effectively measure shallow holes too. The measuring surfaces of the gauge are hardened and polished for very long life. So, there you have it, a range of comparative gauges to round out your toolbox or your metrology department. High quality tools at low, low prices. HaasTooling.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.